Good morning, brothers and sisters. Good morning. I pray that all is well with you, and I pray that the grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus, our Redeemer, is with you also, because we really need it. I would like to talk to you today about influence. Who is influencing you? I was reading, I think I was on Twitter, and I saw this lady from my country, and she was calling herself influencer, like influenceur numérique, like. And then as I was reading it, I was like, why is it? I didn't like that term. And then I realized that the word influence means a lot. Because when you see the very first two letters, IN, and then the rest, it's like something that comes in to move you, to lead you, to direct you, to influence you. But what is that thing? And we can say that the ultimate, I mean, everything is being put in place to bring us to that place where the man of sin, the lawless one, the Antichrist, will come. He's coming. It's not a joke. Honestly, I think that he's still alive. He's already here. He's alive, living and breathing. And this is the introduction. So, who is influencing you? Your drive, your zeal. Where is it coming from? Because when we start seeing the way society is changing, we have terms today that we didn't have 20 years ago, 15 years ago, even 10 years ago. Here in the US, I don't know about you, where you are. I do realize that people watch from all over. We have people who are saying, I was born a man, but the doctor and my parents imposed their will on me, and I don't feel like a man anymore. Although I do have what a man is supposed to have on the body, but I don't like it, so I'm going to go do an ablation. And those, we have one portion who are really going the whole nine yards. They are really changing and becoming what they want, to be happy. They want to please themselves. And when they do that, then they will ask you to change the way you call them, the way you relate to them. I feel sorry for those who are working in Babylon, because now we have terms, even in the capital, I think, Nancy Pelosi changed. They have a new rules. You don't say father, mother, dad, mom, you say parents. Some want to be called they. They, T-H-E-Y, but the thing is there are many inside, that's why they want to be called they. We are not longer talking about one person, but there are many inside. So I heard about people being asking to be called Z, Z-E-E, and we have many terms to call certain people. Now we need to be careful. It's not like when I was growing up, I do realize that I'm aging, and I'm so conservative, where my mom would tell me, you call people, in Africa we call everybody dad, mom, or uncle. You know, uncle, auntie, you don't call them by their first name, you didn't go to school with them. So, at that time, it was okay to call everybody sir, mom, if I don't know them. You know, you give that respect because of they're older than you. But nowadays, certain men don't want to be called sir, they want to be called mom, and it's becoming confusing. But as confusing as things might be, they are influencing us in the way we think, the way we talk, the way we relate to each other. Because how many persons don't we see in the news? Let's just say in 1 month, you see and hear that such and such changed. They are no longer male, they are no longer female, and they don't want to be called this, they don't want to be called that, and they choose to live their lives as female or as male. But so all that is having an impact on us. We cannot pretend that we didn't we are not influenced by it. It does, but is it a good influence? You answer me. And then we have influences in music, in Hollywood, in movies, in every aspect of our lives. We even in the church, because we have pastors here in the US who are going to tell you, I decide to live my life as a female, but I'm going to keep preaching the gospel because God loves me. I was born this way. So that's also influence. And is it good? Is it bad? You answer me. You tell me and you choose. But the thing is, those people are here. And but me, what am I going to do? And as I was thinking about this subject, I saw that all that is bringing us to the coming out of the man of sin. He's coming, he's here, he's alive, and it's not a joke. So for those of you who are not sure yet if you are a Christian or not, or if you love, you need to love everybody, give respect to everybody. We are getting to the point where we'll have to take a stand, where we'll have to choose, where we'll have to make up our mind and decide who is your influencer, who is the one influencing you. And I came to the conclusion that 2021 years ago on Calvary, a young man was crucified. He was 30. He started his ministry at 30, and 33 he was killed. So it was a 3-year long ministry. But what he did, what he accomplished, he chose 12 men. And he placed that his coming and his ministry on their shoulders. That day when they were in the upper room, that fire that came, the fire never died. I realized that it's the same fire that I'm carrying. It's the same influence that I still have coming from those 12 men, from 12 to how many billions are we today? It's awesome. It's amazing. It's grandiose. But what are we going to do? They did what they had to do and they are dead. But we, living today, what are we going to do? What are we going to pass on to the coming generations? What are we going to let come in our mind and from seed to something that is going to bloom? We need to be super careful. We need to be really mindful of what we do, what we hear, what we entertain, and who is influencing you. Those musicians, what are they saying in songs? When you look at videos, I'm like, oh my gosh, I left the world a long time ago. So that's where we are. It's almost funny, but it's very sad, both at the same time, because we have people who say, I'm a believer, but I love such and such musician. I'll go to the concert. I will do what they are telling me to do. Do this, do that. And all that is influencing you. The way you dress, the way you talk, the way, what are you listening to? So that's the purpose of this video, the introduction. What is your influence? Who is influencing you? And for what goal? And that's where we are. We need to ask ourselves, because things are really, really, really changing for the worst. And that's where we are. And I pray that God will give you wisdom. And actually, God is giving wisdom, but you, are you willing to take that wisdom and to be ready for whatever might come tomorrow? Should you take a stand, what are you going to choose? You need to ask yourself that question. Because we are right there on the verge of something. It's going to be good for those who know God, and it's going to be very bad for those who don't know Him. And that's where we are. And that's what I wanted to share with you today. Who is influencing you? Where are you getting your fire from? And how are you taking care of it? And who are you loving so much? Who is filling up your heart? Who? You need to ask yourself that question, because we are living in dangerous times. God bless you, and I'll see you next time.